In the last video, we covered the main topographical openings of the hip. Now, let's do the topography of the thigh and the topography of the leg. So the topography of the thigh consists of the femoral triangle, adductor canal, and the popliteal fossa. So let's start with the femoral triangle. The femoral triangle is a region in the anterior thigh of a triangular zone that will help you identify many structures within this part of the body. And to help you remember the sequence of structures within the femoral triangle, I like to use the mnemonic NAVEL, which will help remember the order from the lateral moving medially. So the femoral nerve is the most lateral structure within the space, followed by the femoral artery, femoral vein, and the lymphatics. So let's now take a closer look at the boundaries of this area. The first thing that we're going to see is that the lateral border is going to be formed by the sartorius muscle, the superior border is going to be the inguinal ligament, and the medial border is going to be one of the adductor muscles, the adductor longus muscle. In other words, the base of the triangle is actually going to be the inguinal ligament, and the apex is directed inferiomedially. Deep to the contents, the floor of this area is going to be made by the Iliopsoas laterally and the Pectineus medially, as you see here. So that was the femoral triangle. Now let's cover a canal called the adductor canal. The adductor canal is a special region within the thigh that is going to allow a passage for the femoral artery and the femoral vein to run down through the thigh. And once they reach the end of the thigh, they're going to go posteriorly into a region called the popliteal fossa, as these two vessels become the popliteal artery and the popliteal vein. To better visualize the canal, I've cut a window through the two of the muscles on the anterior compartment of the thigh. The first of which is the sartorius muscle, as you see here. This is going to form the roof of the adductor canal, meaning that the structures that is going within the space is going to lie deep to the sartorius muscle. Therefore, I needed to cut a window through this muscle to allow us to see a path of those vessels. I've also cut through the vastus medialis, which is one of the large quadriceps muscles, which is going to be on the medial aspect of the knee. Dorsally to this canal, you will see the adductor magnus. So the adductor canal is going to start at the apex of the femoral triangle, and then it's going to go down and end at the popliteal fossa. So that was everything I had for the adductor canal. Now, let's turn the leg around and talk about the popliteal fossa a little bit. The popliteal fossa is bordered by certain muscles you'll find here on the posterior aspect of the knee. It is bound superior medially by the semimembranosus and the semitendinosus. It's bound superior laterally by the biceps femoris. Then inferior medially, we have the medial gastrocnemius muscle of the triceps sura, and then inferior laterally, we'll find the lateral gastrocnemius muscle. Now, deep in the popliteal fossa, we'll find the popliteal artery. We can also find the popliteal vein, as well as the sciatic nerve that give off a branch leaving the popliteal fossa called the common feebler nerve. The popliteal fossa is covered by a fascia, as you see here, called the popliteal fascia, which protects the vasculature located deep within the popliteal fossa. Clinically, you can use the popliteal fossa to palpate for the pulse of the popliteal artery by flexing the leg slightly, as you see here. So that was the topography of the thigh. Now, let's quickly do the topography of the leg. Now, here we have the leg with the crural fascia around it. Let's make a cross-section of the leg and look at it from this perspective. We will see this. We went through all of this when we talked about the crural fascia, but there's going to be a canal here on the posterior side, lying deeply for the posterior tibial artery and vein, as well as for the tibial nerve. There's also going to be a canal for the femoral artery and the femoral vein. And then within the anterior compartment, there's a small canal for the anterior tibial vein and artery, as well as for the deep femoral nerve. So that was all for the topography of the thigh and leg, and I hope that was helpful.